Fendi space boots like an astronaut. I swear if I said it, I mean it. I'm handling business, ain't rapping no shit that I'm not about. Don't ask about a nigga I forgot about. Boss bitches only, you was not allowed. Cut it out. Self-made bitch, how you talking about? Yeah, I got it out of mud, no hand.
What's up, thotties? It's your girl Bree, and if you ain't know, now you know. So, as y'all can tell by that title, today I'm finna be talking about working at UPS in Orlando. If you wanna work at UPS, it's not to it. Everybody was like, this is a hard job, the job not for girls and all that stuff. I don't care what nobody talking about. If you feel that you could do it, then you could do it. So, when you first start working, first of all, you apply. The same day you apply, you get your interview. You get your interview day, great nanny. Go in for your interview. Go through all the little steps and all that. Fill out some papers. And then they do, you always hear a background check to come and all that. A couple of days later, somebody can call you and say that you, somebody will call you or email you and let you know when your start date is. Okay. Your first week from your first week there, you won't be in the classroom. So, like, don't expect to be on the floor as soon as you get, like, as soon as you start working at UPS. Because, baby girl, no, you won't be having to sit in the same, in the whole classroom for a whole week before you start working, before you get on the floor. Within that whole week, you just go, you basically just sign papers, go over all, everything you need to know about working at UPS, how to work the belts, how to stop the belt, how to turn the belt on, like, safety hazards and all that stuff like that. So that you don't get hurt. They show you where everything is located at. Like, so your last day of class, they will show where you will be working at. They also show you like the break rooms, some of the bathrooms. They'll show you the easiest route how to get to your work area because if you a small sort, you all over there. If you in Pakistan, you all over there. If you on Ulu, you all over there. So, basically, yeah, they just put you there to show you everything. They show you how to clock in, clock out, and all that other stuff. So, me, personally, I was working in small sort. I'm going to tell y'all a little bit about what small sort is. So, small sort is really, basically, you print labels, put it on a bag, put the bag on a belt. Like, simple. Y'all may say, oh, that's not that hard. It's not that hard. Okay, yeah, it's not that hard. But when you constantly have to do it over and over and over again, it don't get hard. It gets tiring. It gets irritating. And, like, it just gets so, like, frustrating. Like, it makes you not even want to do it no more. So, basically, what you do is, first of all, you have to take, if any old labels are on the bag is, like, y'all know, like, black trash bag, that's how big the bags was. So, basically, you take off any old labels from, like, any other facility, warehouse that shipped them bags in. You take those labels off and put them in the little pile so you can know which ones got labels and which ones don't. When you first get in there, like, when you're on the floor, the first and second day, they train you. The third day, they watch over you. The fourth day, they watch over you. But after that, they still be watching you, but they're not going to be all up on your back like that. So, you get there, you have to prepare your section. Like wherever you just go to a section where you want to work at, that's where you go in your work area. So once you do that, you put the bags, you refill the bags. First of all, if they got labels on it, you take the labels off and then you put them on the rack so they can be refillable, so you will never run out of bags. Second, after you refill the bags and take the labels off, you have to, well, you don't have to. You can either eat your snacks or you can continue to take off the labels from all the bags. But mind you, you're going to be there for a good 5, 6, 7 hours. So it's better to take all the old labels off while it's no, like, packages coming in and all that, rather than for you to wait until packages start coming and take labels off. Do you understand what I'm saying? That's how I do it. I don't know how everybody else do it, but that's how I do it. I take labels off. Then I hang the, okay, when I first get there, I take the labels off first, like off the bags first, and then I hang the bags, on a rack. And then I just do all that until I'm done with my little area. And then I go back and I continue to take old labels off. That way, it's not hard for me, or I won't forget to take the label off. Because if you forget to take an old label off, and you try to put a new label on there, they're going to say something to you because it could mess up where it's being shipped at. So, basically, yeah. So the packages start rolling in. you need to have to make sure your bag, they're going to teach you all that about the little bags, cover your bag. You need to make sure your slats is pulled down and your bags is like fluffed out so that way your packages can go in it instead of falling over the floor or getting trapped in the little thing. When your bags fill up, me personally, I don't wait till my bags get filled all the way to the tippy top. I wait for my bags to get like halfway filled and then I take them off and I put them on the belt. But the people that I seen, they wait till their bags get filled all the way to the top and then they try to take it off, and that's what it be messing up yet because it be taking more time because you gotta stuff all the bags and do all that stuff. So to avoid all that and then having delays in your bagging, you need to make sure you always change your bags out when they hit the middle, so therefore it don't ever fill. So yeah, so once you do that, it's gonna be a little button that's beside the machine. Whatever button that's beside your machine that you're doing, you just push the button and it's gonna be a little receipt thing that print the labels out for you. So when you push the button, your label automatically comes to the label printer that's closer to you. So all you gotta do is snatch it, put it on the bag, zip in the bag, and throw it on the belt. After you throw your bag on the belt, you have to repeat the step all over again. But this time you have to add two bags and make sure your labels are off, open them, and then go move on to the next bag. Each person has about six or seven bags they have to do like on their own because it's only about four or five people on your side at the, cause it's two sides, so it's only four or five people on each side. And the belts have at least like 20 to 30 little things. I don't know what they call it. They call something that the packages go. They call little bag holders and put it there. It's like 20 or 30 bag holders and it's only four to five people on the line on each side. So you have to be quick and you need to be faster than the machines because when I say the packages don't wait for you, they don't wait for you. The packages are set on a time, so whatever time the packages are scheduled to come down on a thing, that's when they're coming down. The package is not gonna stop. The package is not gonna stop coming just because you're not moving fast enough in order center. If you're not moving fast enough or like you behind and bagging the little jumps, the freaking machine will stop and everybody will be looking at you. Me personally, I never made the machine stop and I only been there for like a couple of like weeks or something now. Since the end of November, seeing like people that been there longer than me make the belt stop. And yeah, that's because for one, they don't move fast. For two, they let all their bags get filled to the top before they want to change them. And that's why I don't do that because that's dumb. Paychecks, depending on how many hours you got, the paychecks are really nice. Like, if you one of the people that just working just because, then like extra money or whatever, then that's the job for you because it's really not that hard and you get back. Like, every Thursday you get paid. First of all, if you get checks, you get paid every Thursday. If you get direct deposit like me, you get paid every Friday. At 12 o'clock, you get paid. So basically, it's still Thursday, but it's just gonna be 12 o'clock on the end of Friday, like midnight. Your first paycheck, like I said, is only gonna be like a couple, probably like $100, not even $100, probably like $90, $80, or something like that. But your paycheck after that, gonna at least, depending on how many hours you had, like how many hours you work, if you see for me, six days a week, about like 6 or 7 hours. And yeah, your paycheck, your second and all that paycheck should at least be like $450 plus. That's what I'm saying, plus. Because if you work in peak, that's another thing. If you work in peak, then that's basically like season, like, because the season and all that, you got to work on the weekends. So you are going on a Saturday, and that's getting more hours though. That's getting more. To me, honestly, small store make the most money because you there on a Saturday. You don't see too many people there on a Saturday. They train you. Your first day, your second day, I already said they train you. Your first and second day, they train you. I mean, but it's really not enough. If you a small store, it's really nothing that you need to be trained on except for on your first day because literally all you do is take the labels off, replace the bags, print the label, put a new label on, and throw it on the belt and then repeat. It's nothing like too hard. You work in the winter, it might be cold outside. It's gonna be cold like before you actually start working. But when you start working, just know it's gonna get hot. Like it's really gonna get hot because you're moving around, you lifting bags and you throwing the bags and it's gonna get hot. They be having a little fan in there just running, but you know, it's still don't know, you still be hot looking dumb. irritated, mad, and all that. They do give you water, or you can bring your own water, or you can. They recommend you not drink, like, bring in soda and get you hydrated. So they prefer you drink water. So they give you water, or you bring your own water. And they also got water fountains, but I never use no water fountain. What it look like using a water fountain in the warehouse? Your work time might be 1:30 one day and 4:00 the next day, and let's say like 2:30 the day before that. So you never have a set scheduled time that you gotta be. That you got to be into work. Like, it's always different times, and you will never get off at the same time that you got off the day before that. It's either you getting off before or after the time that you got off the previous day. If your start, I recommend if your time start at 3:30, you should at least get there around like 3:00 or 3:10. That way you'll have a few minutes to prepare your section, take off all the old labels that you need to, and just chill. Because once you take the labels off and like all your labels off in your little basket, because it's a basket, each person got their own basket with bags in. So once you take your old labels off of those, you can go take some more bags, take labels off of those, so that way you don't have to do all that extra work and still have to get them packages on that. You got to catch Metro. I prefer you not to work Twilight, because that's like afternoon and then going into the night. You can't have your phones in there. Like, they do not allow you to have phones, but you know, some people don't listen. Me personally, I didn't bring my phone in there, but I brought my Apple Watch in there. And one day I was on the phone. I got caught on the phone with him. My supervisor said, you bring your phone in here? I said, no, it's my watch. Because stay tuned for the next video, and 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 the next video.